Okay, now we'll explain lecture 6 in electronics course for English students. Lecture 6 is talking about mesh analysis method. Mesh analysis method is a straightforward method with some predefined steps that we can apply to each to the given electronic circuit to get a unknown value which may be the current value or the volt value. To understand in deep these steps, we apply these steps in this circuit. Given this circuit, we apply the basic steps of mesh analysis. The main step of mesh analysis is to get the M independent current. M independent current means that to get the current that is independent of any other current. In other words, to get the current in a branch that is not common between it and any other mesh. To get the M independent current in detail, we have to get a number of meshes in the circuit first. So the first step is to get a number of meshes in the circuit. Given this circuit, we can find that this circuit has a mesh. Which can be referred as mesh one and has mesh two. Okay. So this mesh has two, this circuit has two meshes, mesh one and mesh two. The independent current, the independent current can be referred as say I1. And this independent current can be represented as or referred as I2. So for mesh one, we have I1. For mesh two, we have I2. Okay. This current I1 passes in which component? In this component or this component or in this component? We say that the M independent current or the current that we will use in our calculations are independent current. I1 and I2 must be independent current. Independent current means that it is the current that passes in a branch that is not common between any other mesh. Okay? So in mesh one, we have this branch. And this branch, I have two branches, branches that contain R1 and V1. And the second branch is the branch that contain R3 and V3. I1 is the current that passes in which branch? I1 is the current that passes in this branch. Why this branch? Because this branch is an independent branch. Independent branch that is not common between any other branch. Any other mesh, okay? I1 is not the current that pass in this branch. Why? Since this branch is common between mesh one and mesh two. So I1 not pass in this branch. So in mesh analysis, first we have to define the number of meshes in the circuit. In the circuit, we have mesh one, which is a closed loop, okay? Then we have to define mesh two, which is a closed loop without any interior component in it. Second step is to get the M independent current. We assume in mesh one we have current I1, and in mesh two we assume that we have current I2. Current I2 is the current that passes in the branch that is independent of any other meshes that is not is a branch that is not common between any other mesh. So the current I1 is the current that passes in R1, okay? In mesh two, ال I2 is an independent current. In I2 pass in which branch? In this branch or in this branch? I2 is the current that pass in mesh 2. Okay, mesh 2 has two branches, the branch that contain R2 and V2 and the branch that contain R3 and V3. I2 passes in which branch? In this branch or in this branch? I2 pass in this branch. Why? Because this branch is an independent branch. This branch is a branch that is not common between any other mesh. As we can see, the branch that contain R3 and V3 is a branch that is common between this mesh and this mesh. Okay, so I2 doesn't pass through this this mesh. Okay, so the second step is to get the M independent current. I have I1 and I2. I1 the current that passes through R1, and I2 the current that passes through R2. Okay, the third step is to apply KVL. KVL is to apply KVL in each loop, in each mesh. Okay. What KVL rule states that KVL states that the summation of voltages in a loop equals zero. Given a loop or given a mesh, the summation of voltages in this mesh equals to zero. For mesh one, I have how many voltages I have? I have V1, R1, R3, and V3. Again, in mesh one, I have voltages V1, the voltage at R1, the voltage at R3, and V3. I have four voltages. So the equation will contain four elements. Then we will equalize it to zero. Again, the third step is to apply KVL in each mesh. So we'll apply KVL in this mesh and apply KVL in this mesh. For applying KVL in mesh one, the equation will contain four elements since we have four voltage values. The KVL equation will be minus V1 plus I1 R1 plus I1 minus I2 multiplied by R3 plus V3 equals zero. Again, the equation will be minus V1 plus I1 R1 plus I1 minus I2 multiplied by R3 plus V3 equals zero. This is the equation that I just mentioned. I1 R1 plus I1 minus R2 multiplied by R3 plus V3 minus V1 equals zero. I have four elements, one, two, three, four. Four elements that is summed together. This element is called V1, this element is called V3, okay? But in this element, I would like to get a voltage value in this branch, but I don't have a voltage value directly. I can get the voltage value using Ohm's law, which states that V equal I multiplied by R. So V equal I multiplied by R. So V in this branch will be I1 multiplied by R1, I1 multiplied by R1. Since the current that passes through this resistance is called I1, okay? For this branch, the current that passes in R3 is called I1 minus I2. The current that passes in this branch is called I1 minus I2, okay? There is two methods that we can use to define the current that passes through R3. But I will mention the simplest method. Simplest method states that to get the current in this branch, you will use the current that the mesh that you are using. Now I'd like to get the KVL in this equation. In this the KVL equation in this mesh. This mesh is mesh one, and the current that passes through it is I1. So to get the voltage value in this element, it will be I1 first, which is the current in this mesh, I1 minus the current that in the other mesh, which is I2. Okay, I1 minus I2. So the voltage value here will be multiplied the voltage value is the current value multiplied by R resistance. Resistance is R3. The current value is I1 minus I2. I1 minus O. The current value in my mesh minus the current value in the other mesh. Okay. For mesh 2. We would like to get the KVL equation in mesh 2. We will do some summation for four voltages, for the voltage value at R2 and voltage value V2, voltage value V3 and voltage at R3. The equation will have four elements summed together. The voltage at this equation will be V2. The voltage at this element will be minus V3. The voltage in this equation will be I2 minus I1. The voltage in this equation will be I2 multiplied by R2. Again, the KVL equation will be plus V2 minus V3 plus I2 minus I1 multiplied by R3 plus I2 multiplied by R2. This is the equation that I just mentioned. It have four elements that is summed together, which are the four voltages in my mesh. The voltage value in this element will be V2. The voltage value in this element will be minus V3. Minus V3 since the current direction in this mesh is clockwise. So it will enter this element in the negative part. So V voltage will be a negative V3. Okay. So it will be positive. Current entering this node will be positive V2. And the current out of this node will be minus V3. The current in this element, the voltage at this element will be the current multiplied by R3. The current multiplied by R3. R3 is given. The current in this resistance will be I2 minus I1, which is I2 is the current in the same mesh I am working on, minus the current I1, which is the current in the other mesh. So the current in this element will be I2 minus I1. I2, since this is the current that I am working on, minus I1, which is the current in the other branch. Okay. Then we will do summation for a voltage at this element, which is V2. Will be I2 multiplied by R2. I2 multiplied by R2. R2 is the resistance value in this element, multiplied by I2 since the current that passes in this element is explicitly I2. Okay? This is the steps of applying the mesh analysis on a given circuit. First, to get the number of meshes in the circuit, then define the M independent current. M independent current is the current that passes through a branch that is independent of any other mesh. Okay. Then we will assign a direction to this current. In mesh one, I have an independent current I1. I will assign a direction to this current, say clockwise. And for mesh two, I will assign a direction. Both of direction must be all clockwise or all anti-clockwise. Okay, so I am doing assumption that the current direction will be in this example is clockwise. Then we will apply the third step is to apply KVL on each mesh. Applying KVL on this mesh will be will be minus v1, since the current is entering in this element in the negative direction. So minus v1 plus I1 R1 plus I1 minus I2 multiplied by R3 plus V3 equals zero. For this KVL, for mesh two, we have I2, we assume the current is clockwise. So the equation will be positive V1, V2 minus V3 plus I2 minus I1 multiplied by R3 plus I2 multiplied by R2, okay? This is the steps in details. Select the M independent mesh current. We'll apply KVL to each mesh. After getting the equations, after getting these equations, equation one and equation two, we solve for mesh current, to solve the two equations to get the I1 and the I2, okay? Now, I would like to highlight that mesh analysis is a method that is used to get unknown variable, unknown value in the circuit. So after getting the two equations, till now we didn't solve, we didn't get any value. So after applying the three main steps of mesh analysis, lower get the number of meshes, get the mesh independent current, apply KVL. Till now we get two equations, but we didn't get any value. So we have to solve, the fourth step is to solve these two equations together. We have two equations with two unknown values, the I1 and I2. We have all the values, the R1 and the R3 and the V3 and the V1. We didn't have, we didn't know the current of I1 and I2. So we have to solve this equation with this equation. Two equations with two variables will be solved easily. So this is the first main step of mesh analysis. This example, in this example, we have to apply mesh analysis in this example also. So first we have to define the number of meshes. For this example, we have this mesh, which we can refer as mesh one, and this mesh, which can be referred as mesh two, and then we have this third mesh, which can be referred as mesh three. Okay. Then we define the M independent current in each mesh. We assume that we have in this mesh I1 and this mesh we have I2, and this mesh we have I3. Okay. And again, current I1 is the current that passes in a branch that is independent of any other meshes. So, and current I1 is the current that passes through this resistance. For I2, I2 is the current that passes in a branch in this mesh, but the branch that is independent of any other mesh. Okay? So it will be this resistance. Why this resistance? Since resistance 12 is common between this mesh and this mesh. Resistance 2 is common between this mesh and this mesh. But resistance 1 is not common between any other mesh. It exists in only mesh 2, okay? For this mesh, I3 is the current that passes through 24. Since 24 is a resistance that exists only in mesh 3. But resistance 6 is a resistance that exists in mesh 3 and mesh 1. And resistance 12 is a resistance that exists in mesh 3 and mesh 2. So it is a common between two meshes. So I3 is not passing through this resistance, passing through this resistance only. This is for the two steps, KVL and the M independent current. Third step is to apply KVL for each mesh. For this mesh, we have a current passing in this direction clockwise. So the KVL equation will be KVL entering this element in the next terminal. So it will be minus 125 plus I1 multiplied by 1 plus 6 multiplied by I1 minus I3 plus I2, sorry, L2 multiplied by I1 minus I2. Okay. For again, the equation will be minus 125 plus 1 multiplied by I1 plus 6 multiplied by I1 minus I3 plus 2 multiplied by I1 minus I2. Okay. As we explained before, any voltage at a resistor will be the multiplication of I and R, I multiplied by R. The resistance value here is 1, the resistance value here is 6, the resistance value here is 2. So it will be 1 multiplied by the current, we know I, 6 multiplied by the current, will 2 multiplied by the current. The current value in this branch will be I1. Okay, since this branch is not common between any other mesh, so the current I1 is passing through this resistor. Then for this resistor, the current will be I1 minus I2, the current in my mesh minus the current in the other mesh. The current in this resistor will be I1 minus I3. For I2, the current will be I1 minus I2, since this resistor is common between two meshes, okay? We will mention the equation of applying the KVL on this mesh directly. It will be minus 125 plus 2 multiplied by I2 minus I1 plus 12 multiplied by I2 minus I3 plus 1 multiplied by I2, okay? For this equation or for this mesh, we have a KVL which equals to 24 multiplied by I3 plus 12 multiplied by I3 minus I2 plus 6 multiplied by I3 minus I1. Okay, so this is for mesh analysis in this circuit. There is some special cases in mesh analysis. Special cases that we apply mesh analysis normally, then we can do further step in our processing. One of the main special cases is the existence of dependent sources. In this example, I have this dependent source which contain voltage dependent source, and its voltage value is 15 multiplied by I5. Okay, how to apply KVL in this apply mesh analysis in this example? What is the main problem of existing dependent source in this circuit? While solving with the existence of dependent source, while solving without the existence of dependent source, we have in this example mesh 1 and mesh 2 and mesh 3. So we'll have three equations with three variables. Okay, so the equations will be solved. But in this special case contain dependent source with another variable. So we'll have three equations, but we have four variables in the equation. So we have to substitute by this value with any other known value. Okay. Let's mention the equations explicitly and see the problem. The steps of applying KVL is to define the number of meshes. We have this closed mesh, this closed loop is mesh, and this closed loop is mesh, and this closed loop is mesh, okay? lambda independent current, we assume the current passing in this direction in this mesh is m is I1, and this is I2, and this is I3. Okay. The current in this mesh is called I1. I1 passes through resistor I1. Okay. The KVL of this equation will be I1 multiplied by 1 plus in this direction. So we'll have 4 multiplied by I1 minus I3 plus 5 multiplied by I1 minus I2, okay? This is the example again. We will have 1 multiplied by I1 plus 4 multiplied by I1 minus I3 plus 5 multiplied by I1 minus I2. This is the KVL equation for this mesh. For this mesh, I will have negative 15 plus 5 multiplied by I2 minus I1 plus 20 multiplied by I2 minus I3, okay? So if the branch is a common between other many meshes, its current will be the main current minus the current in other mesh. So this the current in this branch will be 5 multiplied by I2 minus I1. Since I am working now on this mesh, I am getting the KVL equation of this mesh. So its main current will be I2. So it will be 5 multiplied by I2 minus I1. For this, I will have 20 multiplied by I2 minus I3. Okay? For this equation, for this mesh, I will have 4 multiplied by I3 minus I1 plus 50 multiplied by I5. This is the voltage value in this element. Plus 20 multiplied by I3 minus I2, okay? Till now we have three equations. Question for this mesh, I have three equations, but I have four variables, I1, I2, I3, and I5. So I have to substitute I5 with any other value, okay? Any other value in terms of I1 and I2, I3, to have only three equations with three variables and solve them. How to solve this problem? How to get the value of I5 in terms of any other current of this current? In the given circuit, I have I5 is the current that passes in this direction. I5 is the current that passes in this direction. So the current will be I5 is the current that passes in this direction. So the current will be I2 minus I1. Again, I5 is the current that passes in this direction. What is the current that passes in this direction? If I have I2 clockwise, it will be passing in this direction, entering to 20. This is the same current, the same bus of I5. So I5 will be I2 minus I3. Okay, for this branch, I have I3 entering this node, which is the inverse current of inverse direction of this branch. So I will substitute I5 in any in all equations by I2 minus I3. This is for the first special case. Second special case of mesh analysis is the existence of independent current source, but at the outside of the circuit. I have in this figure shows a special case, which is the existence of independent current at its place will be outside of the circuit. Okay. How to solve this equation, or what is the main, how to solve this special case, or what is the main problem of this equation? While processing is the mesh analysis, I have to get a number of meshes. This is mesh one, and this is mesh two, and this is mesh three. Then I will define the M independent current. This is I1, I2, I3. Then after applying KVL, I will apply KVL in this equation, I couldn't apply KVL in this equation. Why? Because in this mesh, I don't have a voltage value in this element. So I couldn't do summation of voltages in this loop. I didn't apply KVL in this mesh, since I don't have voltage in this element. I don't have its the voltage value of this element. Okay. So this is the problem. This is a special case: is the existence of independent current source outside in the outermost of the circuit. It's a problem is that we couldn't apply KVL in the KVL that contain in the mesh that contain the current source. How to solve it? First of all, we will apply KVL in this mesh normally. Then in this mesh, we said that the current is I3. The current in this branch is I3. So I3 is passing in the clockwise direction. Okay. It will be the inverse sign of this branch. I3 will be entering this element in A in the negative part. So I3 will be equal to negative 16. Okay, the I3 will be equal to negative 16. So we will solve these two equations together to get the I1 and the I2. And the I3 will be negative 16. Since the direction of the I3 is clockwise, the direction of this current is negative, in the inverse direction of this of I3. Okay. So this all for the second special case of mesh analysis. This is another example that contains the two main special cases that we talk about. This example contains a special case of the existence of current source outside in the outermost of the circuit, and contain independent dependent source. Okay. For the other, for the first example, it was containing voltage dependent source. This figure contain current dependent source. Okay. So how to solve this problem? We can solve it as we learn. First, we have to define number of meshes. We have mesh one, mesh two, mesh three, mesh four. The sorting, this is mesh one, this is mesh two, mesh three, mesh four. Okay. You are not limited with any sorting. You can choose the sort you would like, you prefer. So assuming this is the mesh one and this is mesh two, mesh three, mesh four. So the current in this branch will be I1, I2, I3, I4. We can get the KVL in this equation normally. KVL in this mesh normally. For this mesh, we can say that in the I2 equals the negative of 3I1, the current current in this mesh is called I2. The I2 value equals to the I direction is clockwise. It equals to it is the same current that is the same current that pass in this L component, but with the negative direction. So I2 will be negative 3 I1, which is the current value in this branch. Okay. For this element, we have this is called I4. So I4 will be equal negative 5. The I4 clockwise entering this in the negative direction. So the I4 equal negative. Negative what? Negative 5. Okay. So this is all for this special case. The existence of dependent source, the existence of a current source outside of the circuit. Okay? This current source can be dependent or independent. The third special case is the existence of independent source, but in the circuit, in the middle of the circuit. This is the third special case. How to solve this problem? This problem has two solutions. We will use, we will solve using only one solution for now. First, we'll apply the three main steps of KVL. We have mesh one, mesh two, mesh three. Mesh one, say mesh two, mesh three, okay? Assuming the current in this mesh is called I1, this is I2, this is I3. Applying the KVL, we can apply the KVL in this mesh normally, but we couldn't apply the KVL in this mesh since it contained a current source here, so we couldn't do some measure of voltage values since it is a current source. For this mesh, we couldn't apply the KVL in this mesh also, since it contains a current source, which is not a voltage value. So we couldn't apply the KVL in this mesh and this mesh. We have only one equation with two values, so we couldn't solve it. To solve this special case, we have to do something called source transformation. To apply source transformation to this element, by replacing this element from the circuit by a voltage source, okay? To solve the special case of existence of independent current source, we use source transformation method. Source transformation replaces a current source with a voltage source, but with the condition that we have current source is parallel with another resistance. We have to have this part of the circuit to solve this problem using the source transformation. The current source must be parallel with another resistor value. So we will replace this component of this part of the circuit by this branch. L6 remains the same, L30 remains the same, L4 remains the same, and L75 remains the same, but 5 and 30 are replaced with a voltage source series with a resistor. The current source parallel with a resistor is replaced by voltage source series with a resistor. The values of the resistor and the voltage source, the values of the resistor will be the same value of the old resistor, but the value of the voltage source will be the multiplication of the current source and the resistor, 30 multiplied by 5, will be 65. So this is how the problem can be solved. Then we will apply KVL normally. We will have mesh 1 and mesh 2, I1 and I2. um, applying equivalences mesh, applying equivalences mesh, we will have two equations with two values. We solve to get the values of I1 and I2. Okay, this is all for this presentation.